Hi everyone, I'm Srihari from B2B team. So today we'll be talking on how to convert relational data to a JSON format using data processor transformation in developer client. So the first thing you need to consider is the licenses, which all licenses are required for data processor to process the relational data to a JSON format. And we'll see in data developer client how to create a project mapping and data processor for relational to JSON. We'll see, we'll provide a sample relational input to data processor, and we'll see what is the output which it will provide. Okay. Now, let me open the admin console and then show you what are the licenses required. So if you see, this is the admin console which I have. So these are the two licenses which are required: unlimited data processors transformation in model repository service and unstructured data. So these two are required. So you need to make sure that this is there in your licenses before you proceed something. So yeah, now let's go to the developer client and then connect to this MRS. So first you can connect to the MRS. So you need to create a project. You have to just click on new project. I'll just give a name like relational to JSON test. Click on next, and you can just provide this permissions based on whichever user you want to make it access. So that is something different. So now you need to create a mapping for this. So you just say mapping relational to JSON. So relational to JSON in the sense, the data which I am getting is in a relational format. It might be from some table or from a flat file also, and if it might be from some other transformations. But what I mean when I am telling relational to JSON in the sense, in the data processor, the input is multiple ports. So I have n number of ports. I will get the input in n different ports, and I want to take this particular input from n different ports, and then I have to I have to process it and then get a one single output output buffer, output file, or output data which is in a JSON format. I have to make sure that this data is taken and then it is processed to provide us the JSON file. Okay, so now let me just as a sample, I'll just create a normal flat file data object. So for a demo purpose, so I'll create a flat file data object in this way. So let's say I have a data processor, something like this. So I am creating a new data processor. So you just need to click on new and transformation, and then so now you have to use by wizard, because wizard option is readily available to convert relational data to JSON format. So you can just click on next. In the input, what we needs to be selected, it's relational data, and in the output format you need to select JSON, because we need to get a JSON file. So in this place, JSON schema, you have to provide the schema file of how you want how the JSON for output should look like. So let me consider one example. Okay, let's say I want to get a JSON file in this format. So for I might get the data in this way, like Alex Rodriguez is first first information of a student, and the second information is David Crosby and Anna Watson. So consider I get data in relational format for these three records of students. So I am expecting this kind of JSON file as an output from DP. So what you have to do is you can give JSON sample file, or you can provide JSON schema. So I'll select JSON sample file here. Okay, and this is the file which we just saw, and I'll click on finish. So you can also select JSON schema. So it is better if you select JSON schema, because sometimes there in the schema we have a definition of a blank element, and it might not be there in the JSON file. So you can select the schema which will contain all the definitions, and if the data file doesn't contain, or if it contains optional element, it will also be rendered. So as a test example, I am selecting a JSON file. So you have to select like this and click on finish. So once you click on finish, you will see something like this. So what I have to have in this file, I have to have two fields, like for example first name and last name, which is required. So first let us see how the DP is now. So I have dragged it. So if you see, there is a I created a DP with two fields. If you see, there are two more fields which are added. So these fields are added because these two are child elements of my root element. So in order to understand, so this is my root element. I have multiple child elements, like this is my child element, this is my child element, and this is the child element. So you have to have in the relational format, you need to specify what is the key for this and the foreign key for this. So what happens, so for this particular child element, I need to tell data processor that this is the key which it is associated, and then it will be able to give the data in the right way. So for example, if I have one here and foreign key as one, it means that the parent value is one and the foreign key value is one. So this and then you can have like two or three, so you need to have the value for that. So for example, I'll show you the input file, how it looks like for me. Okay, so clear. See, I have a file in this way. Okay, I have a file which has 1 2 3 4. So my key is changing here. Okay, and I can now pass this file. So I have three fields here, so I have to make sure that I have three fields in my input. Okay, now I'll have to select the reader file. So here it should be test.txt, because my file name is test.txt. okay, so let me drag this object. Okay, now the first name and the last name goes as it is. Okay, now the key. So key value for first, and I am keeping the same for the foreign key also. So even if it is same for foreign key, it is It should be okay because the main primary key which needs to be changed every for every iteration is this one. So if this changes, it doesn't matter. So yeah, so now let's see what is the output when I run the data viewer on this particular element. Let me okay. Now, if I click on F8, yeah. So, if you see here, I got four records, which was there in the input. So for example, if you have a table here, you are connected to database, or else after database, after tables, you have a lot of transformation in between here. Before DP, so you can send the data in that way. That means it's a relational. So here I am sending data through ports, so that is why it is relational. Now when I run a DP on this, so I should get the output which has the JSON format, whichever we were looking in this way. Okay, let's see if it comes or not. Yeah, it came. Now if you see students, first name Alex Rodriguez. So it comes something like this. Now you can just create and add target, and based on whatever output you want. So you can just put it something like this, and then you can save it. Okay, now if you run the mapping, you should get the output. I'm running the mapping now. Let's see if the mapping is successful or not. Yeah, it is successful, so there are no issues. Now let's go to the target directory, and let's see what is the output. So the one which was created just now was this one. Okay, vi, yeah, sorry, yeah. So these are the output which we just got for the mapping which we ran just now. Okay, yeah, this is also available in video in the document. So 502073 KB. Yeah, thank you. We would like to hear the feedback from you. Let us know. Thank you.